again, you don't get too many crowds like this in the amateur golf. I mean, it's got to be the finals of a U.S. mid-amateur or the maybe the Porter Cup or the Northeast. It's really the majors. This rivals all of those.
Five star from everyone at the everyone that works at the entire staff, from the people in the locker room to the outside service to the head pro to the the greens with the superintendent. Everything they did was just top notch, and yeah, probably one of the best amateur events I've ever played.
You know, it's important that when I go back to Savannah and Sea Island, that people ask me, hey, how was the Gasparilla? We don't get down to Tampa too often, and when you have the opportunity to come down here, especially to come to this golf course and this club, I always do it. People back home know Palmasia right now, and they know the reputation it has because I'm one of your biggest fans.
The tournament was phenomenally organized, had great practice rounds. Everything was just perfect here. It's a great place to come play golf.
The Gasparilla Invitational drips with history, with many of the game's greatest names woven into the fabric of its yesteryear. Palmasia Country Club was born in the Roaring Twenties, originally designed by the legendary Donald Ross, and recently re-energized by the world-renowned designer Bobby Weed. Legends have walked these fairways in the Gasparilla Invitational. Walter Hagen, the Squire Gene Sarazen, Henry Picard, Ralph Goodall, and so many more. Up until 1935, the Gasparilla Open was the top money PGA tournament in the United States. That year, Hagen, a legendary carouser, showed up just 2 minutes before his tee time, sauntered up without a single practice swing, and fired off a sterling 64. It took a clutch birdie-birdie finish at holes 17 and 18 for the Hague to win by one shot. This victory at the Gasparilla Open at Palmasia was the last individual professional tournament that Walter Hagen would ever win. The tremendous history only adds to the aura of what the Gasparilla Invitational has become, universally respected as one of the most enjoyable and best-run amateur tournaments in the world.
Champion, please welcome from Greensboro, North Carolina, Scott Harvey.
It's definitely one of the funnest events you play in all year. You got absolutely perfect greens, and like they were talking about, it's a real short golf course, but it plays really long and really difficult. And then you got obviously the great crowds, and the people running the tournament do such a good job, and it just makes a great event.
The course, the welcoming membership, and the talented field further combine to make playing in the Gasparilla one of golf's most unique experiences. Chairman of the Masters Competition Committee, Fred Ridley, a former U.S. amateur champion, is a longtime member at Palmasia and a frequent competitor in the prestigious Gasparilla Invitational.
I've never had so much fun at a tournament in a long time. Having dinner with the members and speaking by Steve Melnick and Fred Ridley and Chris Sullivan was probably the highlight of the week, I think.
Oh, everything. From when you get here, they take care of you for everything, from the locker to the food to the drinks, for everyone and your guests. So it was, the cookout was incredible, everything about it. It's a five-star event.
Other U.S. amateur champions like Hal Sutton, Bob Murphy, and Buddy Alexander have won the Gasparilla, and many mid-major champions as well. The Gasparilla has been a bucket list item for the game's greatest amateur players for the last 60 years, with the diabolical greens prepping the players for some of the game's greatest courses like Augusta.
They are as fast as Augusta, no question. Absolutely no question. They're Bermuda, though, so that makes them a little bit more tricky. but yeah, they're as fast as Augusta for sure.
Well, it's such a unique place. It's only a small piece of property. The greens are extremely fast. Our superintendent, Carson Camps, gets the course in tremendous shape, and it's such a strong test of golf because it's target golf, and it's very tough to score here, and players find it fair but challenging.
One of probably the hardest little golf course I've ever played. And not only that, it's only 6,300 on paper, but God, it plays every bit of that.
While the rich history and tremendous playing conditions set the table, it's the pageantry and hospitality of the membership that makes the Gasparilla Invitational so special in the minds of the game's greats. Elaborate parties and uncompromising cuisine will welcome all golfers, making our guests truly feel like part of our family.
They want you here. You know, some places you go and you feel like you're taking up their golf course, and you got a sense of hurry up and get out of my way. But, these people want you here. They embrace you as a player, and it makes you feel really special.
The whole reason I come here every year is because of the club members. They're fantastic. You feel like a member yourself by the time you leave, so it's really good. And the turnout today was as good as I've seen in a long time. You know, they feed us well. I gain weight the whole time I'm down here. We stay up too late. The members are a lot of fun, a lot of good storytelling. But the tournament itself has a lot of good heritage, and I just love the golf course.
Playing in the Gasparilla Invitational would create memories for a lifetime. Winning the Gasparilla links your name to some of the greatest to ever play the game. Join us.
Congratulations.